Now we are going to see the parallel resistors. Already we have seen the series resistance. In parallel resistance, the diagram will be like this. Different loops will be there. For example, the first resistors, the second resistance, and third resistance. Not in a end-to-end connection. One after another, the connection will be there. Here it is not a single loop. There will be a three loops. How many resistor you are connecting, that many loops will be there. Battery, key, and an ammeter. The first in the series connection, we are seeing that I is same, passing of current is same, but the potential difference V is different for each resistance. Here the current negative to positive, the flowing of current will be separated at this point, isn't it? So the I will be varied for each resistance. I will be varied for each resistance. In series connection, the current passing through the resistance is same. Here the current passing through the resistance is separated. I1, I2 and I3. Then according to the Ohm's law, we know that V is equal to IR. Here V is common because the potential drop between these two points only, not some other point, only these two points. In single loop, different points the voltage drop is there. Here the voltage drop is same, it is flowing between the two points. Here if there is any problem in one connection also, the other will be working out. So as we studied about the tap connection, in a series connection, if there is a block, in any one point in series connection, the other two will not be worked out. Here it is not like that, it is parallel one after another. Even here the current, the loop is cut out. This loop is closed loop, closed conducting path. In this loop, if there is any damage, the other two closed loop, the current will be passing. In parallel connection, the current will be flow even if any connection is not there. Even the first loop, second loop and third loop. In series connection, it's a single loop. If there is any break, the current, the passage of current won't be there. So what I said, the current is splitting there. So the first equation, we will change writing I is equal to V by R. So I can write I1, I2 and I3. Yes, V by R1, V by R2 and V by R3. Total current, adding all the three equation, I1 plus I2 plus I3 is equal to, commonly you just take the V outside, within the bracket you will be getting 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Isn't it? Then effective current will become capital I, is equal to V times of the same bracket, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Then instead of I can write by the Ohm's law V by R. R in parallel is equal to V times of this bracket, 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. So cancelling V on both the sides, will be getting 1 by Rp. Effective resistance in parallel is equal to 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the effective resistance in parallel. Once again, the circuit will be like this. Parallel connection of resistance. Here the current, flowing of current will be splitting for all the three resistance. So our Ohm's law formula, V is equal to IR. Then I is equal to V by R. Why I am writing I is equal to V by R? Here I is going to be change. So I1 plus I2 plus I3. Instead of that I am writing in formula the first one, second one and third one. Adding all these things, effective current I, I1 plus I2 plus I3, V within the bracket 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. I is equal to V times of within the bracket reciprocal of the resistance addition. Then instead of I will be writing V by Rp, that is equal to V times of within the bracket same, cancelling V on both the sides. Both the sides will be getting effective resistance 1 by Rp is equal to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the effective resistance derivation for resistance in parallel. Okay.